guys, welcome back to Auto Repair guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video guys, we'll be working here on a Dodge Journey, which is the same as Fiat Fremont guys. And what we'll show you today guys, how to remove and replace the passenger seat belt, front right seat belt. Stay with us, that's what we'll be doing guys. In the meantime, we're going to have more than 200 videos on this car, so please subscribe. Our goal is to save you as much money as we can by teaching you guys how to fix your car for free. So let's start on the process now. All the tools and parts guys that we use will be listed in the description of the video below. So let me show you what we need to do now. Okay, right here. Okay, we have that cap. Okay, that we need to remove. This lid. Okay. Let me show you how you can remove it. You grab it with the tool. Okay, and you pull it out. Okay, like that. Next. Right here we have one bolt that we need to remove. Okay, this bolt right here. This bolt guys is with a Torx 50 star looking bit. Again, you will be able to find the tools listed in the description of the video below. So let's see if we can take that thing off. It's really, really tight, or we have to get the bigger bar. Okay, perfect. This is the bolt. Do not lose it. Now, what do we need to do next? Right here, guys, this cover, we need to pop it up. You can find the plastic prying tool that we use listed again in the description of the video below. For your convenience, guys, all that we do takes quite a bit of time. So please subscribe. Hopefully, we can save you quite a bit of money. Okay, the two pieces are stuck together. Okay, this is the clip right there. Next, we need to open the rear door. Okay, and right here we have the same thing that we need to remove. Okay, that piece. One here, one clip here, and one there. So, three clips together. And this piece is loose. Now, we're going to pull that piece out. It has four clips. One, two, three, four clips. Okay, out of the way. Like that now. So, let me show you what we'll be doing here now. Okay, you can see that little bitty cap. Okay, we need to pull that cap out because there is a hidden bolt. Now, another thing, guys, every time, okay, you do any work on the seat belts, you have to disconnect your car battery at least 1 hour before the repair. So please do that. We have the video on the channel if you don't know how to disconnect the car battery. So that will be the first thing to do. Our battery is already disconnected because it's part of the airbag system. You don't want that thing to blow in your face, kill you, or anything like that. Consider this entertaining video, not a how-to video. Torx guys, Torx 15, and we're going to remove one screw now. Okay, the screw just, we dropped it inside, so we're going to find it when we remove the belt. Okay, grab that piece now, it has a couple clips. Okay. So, let's see what else is holding here now. Okay, perfect. Because you don't want to pry too much because you can damage your headliner there. Now, we have a few more things to disconnect now, guys. Okay, we need to remove that bolt. Okay, this bolt is the one holding the belt. Okay, I just found our screw. Okay, right here. You can see it was stuck on this piece. So that's a good thing, we found our screw. With the same tool, we're going to remove, okay, that bolt. Okay, it's almost out. Perfect. Now, you can see this thing right here. It has clips that you need to push in from the outside. So if I get a small screwdriver, okay, check it out now. This is where the clip is. Push in, and one on the other side like that. Perfect. This is your belt. Now we have one more bolt that we need to remove on the bottom right there. Okay, with the same Torx too. Okay, and this one is super tight, so what we'll do, okay, let me grab it quick because it will be a little bit more comfortable for me, so let me do that. Okay, wow, I passed the camera. No, no. So it looks like our socket is a little bit messed up. We'll get a bigger tool and we'll continue. So we guys need to get the big tools in action, okay? And let's see if it's going to help any now. Okay, that thing is ridiculous. Okay, if that doesn't work, what I'm going to do, I'll get this one. Okay, why that thing is so tight? This is due to the fact that it has thread locker. Okay, so that's gonna take a little bit of time. What we'll do, okay, we're going to take it off and show it towards the end when we're ready to remove it. So we'll get the impact now, guys, okay? Now let me show you. Okay, all that is thread locker right here. That's why, guys, it's so complicated to remove that bolt. And you need to apply a generous amount of thread locker, guys. You need to check the manual to see if it's a high strength or not. So next, we'll pull the belt. Now, you have to be extremely careful. I'll never ever recommend to use anything metal here because you can explode your belt. If it was in a crash and it's burnt, you don't need to worry about that. But let me show you now. Okay, let me show you now what you need to do. So that piece, okay, that orange piece, it needs to go up. Okay, like this one, check it out. And now never ever twist the connector left or right, you just pull it straight up. You might wiggle it a little bit. Yeah, okay, and that thing is one of the teeth is still holding right here, I see, on this side. So, don't do what I do, right here. Okay, I'm going to see why this thing is still stuck. Okay, perfect, just like that. And you can see, guys, that's how you remove the seat belt. Replacement is the same way we took it apart. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe and see you guys next time.